problem. Look, where are you? I'm in front of the mall just like I said I did. And you're not here.
Deny thy father and refuse thy name. Or if thou wilt but be sworn, my love, and I'll no longer be Capulet.
Okay, I know you're all freaked out about how my dad makes fun of your name. Yet, over it. How many times do I have to tell you? It doesn't matter what your name is. So your name's Romeo. Big deal. I don't care. It could be worse. What about that girl in biology class whose name is Rainbow? Just go by your middle name. And if it makes you feel any better, I'll go by my middle name. And we'll be Theodore and Marguerite. How's that?
Tis but thy name that is my enemy.
What are you getting so freaked out about for anyway? It's just like a name. It's not like some deformed face that can't kiss or something. You know I like it no matter what you're called.
Thou art thyself, though, Montague. What's Montague? It's nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part belonging to a man.
Romeo, I don't have time to text this, so pick up. I know you're there. Look, nobody cares about your name but you and my dad, and he's not dating you. I am, and I don't care. Doesn't have anything to do with how cool your hair is, how excellent your tattoo is, or how totally wicked your pierced tongue is.
What's in a name that which we call Rose by any other name would smell as sweet? So if Romeo, were he not Romeo called, retain that dear perfection which he owes without that title.
It's like when we got our dog, right? And my mom wanted to call him Arfie. Well, even if we had called him Arfie instead of Gandalf, I'd just love him just as much as I do now. So, even if your mom had called you something even stupider than Romeo, you'd still be like the hottest boy in school.
Romeo got that name, and that name which is no part of thee, take all myself.
Get over yourself, okay? I'm going over to the food court, so whenever you're ready to grow up, you can meet me there and buy me some nachos or something.